So now we have four zones built out for all of our HVAC zones in our facility. And remember that one of the end goals for our final AF model would be to calculate the power usage for each of the pieces of equipment in each zone. And then we'd want to roll up the total from all the equipment to the zone level. And then we want to roll up through our zones eventually to a top level building element. So let's go ahead and build that top level element, and then see how we can put all our zones underneath it. So I'll just go to the elements collection here, build a new element, and it's going to be called OSIsoft Research Lab. And for now we won't have any attributes for it. That'll be something that would be down the road once the roll-up calculations are established. So I'll just go ahead and check that in. That's very important when you're building a new element like this, that you're going to put other elements underneath, that you go ahead and check that element in. Because until it's checked in, it's not officially in the database. And so you run the risk if you move, say, you know, one of your zones underneath this OSIsoft Research Lab and it hasn't been checked in initially, then the database doesn't really know where to put that zone, and you run the risk of losing your zone element and all the structures underneath it. So just a word of warning there. Make sure when you're building a new parent element that you're going to move things underneath to go ahead and check that in before you start moving stuff. So now I have my research lab, and let's see how we can move our zones underneath. Now in the previous video I talked about that we could copy and paste new copies of an element using a drag and drop method where we held control and then drag and dropped. Similarly, if we want to move elements, we can hold down the shift key and drag and drop. So I'll press the shift key and then drag and drop zone 1 underneath the research lab. I'm going to want a parent-child reference for this. It's a strong reference type. I'll talk a little bit more about references later. But in this case, I'd want a parent-child reference. Go ahead and click OK, and you can now see that my zone 1 is underneath my OSIsoft research lab. If I wanted to move the rest of these in bulk, I could just go up here and click on my elements collection. And I can see these other three are here. I'll use a shift click to highlight them all. And then again, hold down shift and drag and drop to my research lab. I want parent child references. And now you can see all four of my zones appear under the OSIsoft research lab level. So let's go ahead and check that in. And now we'd be all ready for the future work of calculating our powers for the equipment and eventually rolling that up to zones and then rolling up from zones to the OSIsoft Research Lab. And those roll-up calculations are something that will be covered in the next AF course on adding analytics and notifications to your AF structure. So now we've seen how we can move and copy elements. The last thing I'd like to point out is making a reference to an element. So where this can be useful is when you need two different views or two different ways to organize the same assets within a database. So let's say this research lab and organization by zone is useful for doing our HVAC analysis, but maybe the maintenance department wants a simplified view of just an equipment list. So let's build them a new element, and we'll just call it equipment list. Go ahead and check that in. And let's go ahead and put our zone 1 equipment under there. So here, let's just do the blower first. If I drag and drop without holding shift or without holding control, so just a simple drag and drop with no keyboard interaction, that's going to do is it's going to create a reference to that blower 01 element. And now I have the choice between doing a parent-child or a weak reference. In this case, I'm going to choose the weak reference type, and I'll explain why. Let's go ahead and check that in. Now you can see that we have a new blower element here, and it has this little white box with a little black arrow in it, as if it's pointing back to something else. And in fact, that's what it's doing. It's a reference. It's pointing back to this original element. So an element reference is essentially linked to the original element. So if I were to go in and make any changes to this original element, if I changed, say, a default value for some numerical attribute. That change would get passed to this blower 01 reference element. And so this blower 01 is always in sync with this blower 01 up here, so I only have to make a change one place in the hierarchy, and it's propagated to the other elements that reference that original element. Now the reason I chose a weak reference down here is because I just have a different organizational list here, and I want to make sure that if I were to remove this blower 01 from the zone 1, say, you know, if I went down here and deleted the reference, I would also want the reference in the equipment list to be deleted as well. Now, for some reason, you wanted the element references in the equipment list to remain intact, even though you're deleting the original element. We could have made the reference type here a parent-child reference, and then, since that's a strong reference to the equipment list, this blower 01 would become a permanent element if we deleted the blower 01 up here. So I know that's a bit confusing, but if you do a bit more reading in the PySystem Explorer user guide, it should start to make more sense, but it's a good practice. If you're going to have two different views, use a weak reference down here so that when you remove something in the original hierarchy, it also gets removed from the secondary hierarchy. So we can also go and move a couple more of these. And then I'll show you quickly how we can use the PyBuilder, say, to move the 2, 3, and 4 equipment underneath the equipment list here. Go ahead and check that in. Let's go to our builder, and I'll just make another sheet again. I'll go to elements, and basically I just need the reference type, and the element name, and then we already get the parent and name through the required columns. And the object type. And then I want to make sure I have this element references checkbox selected. So I'll go ahead and hit OK. And we see that that pulls in all of my element references. So you see the object type is element reference. It tells me the reference type is a weak reference. It shows me the path to the original element that we're referencing. And it shows me the parent of the element reference. So as we saw here, equipment list is the parent for these three references, and they each reference back to these original elements, which have the path of OSIsoft Research Lab and Zone 1. So that's all right here. So again, I can use Excel to quickly delete some rows I don't want, and then we can just copy these. Can just change this guy first. So we'll change, do a Control H here and change 1 to 2. And we'll get this block, change from 1 to 3. And do the last block to get 1 through 4. And so now we see we have the proper references to all the Zone 2 equipment, Zone 3 equipment, and Zone 4 equipment. And they're going to be element references underneath the equipment list. So let's go ahead and publish that to our database. We'll use a create-only option. Looks like it works successfully. And if I go here and refresh, I now have a full equipment list with all of my equipment referenced. So that's just a brief word on moving and referencing elements and building alternative hierarchies. One last thing I wanted to mention as far as moving elements around in the hierarchy is how it would affect the client tools where you might have displays built. In this case, the effect is nothing happens. As we saw, we took all of our zone elements and moved them from under the elements collection to under this OSIsoft Research Lab. So we've effectively changed the path to all these different attributes. But if I go back to my element relative display for the zone monitoring, you can see that everything still functions normally. That's because I think I mentioned earlier that all these elements and attributes and everything in AF have these unique IDs. Here I've just gone through and done an import of some elements. And I've made sure to select this unique ID attribute here. So you can see when I import, I get the unique ID for each different element in my hierarchy that I've imported. And you can see that those long strings of numbers and characters and letters are all unique for each one of these elements. Same thing applies, as I mentioned earlier, if you were to go in and rename an element. So I can go here and change the name of this. If I was a really poor speller, which I am actually, and I change the name of that, you can see that it's updated the name here, but I still find all the same data that I was getting before. So I just wanted to take note of that, that if you're moving things around in your hierarchy or changing the name of elements, you don't have to worry about breaking all your displays.